Then the Lord said to Cain, "Where is Abel your brother?" He said, "I do not know. Am I my brother's
keeper?"
So first of all, Zimbabwe's ethnic situation, if I can put it, is not the most complex compared to other African countries. Now, those who know Nigeria, those who know Zambia, those who know Ethiopia, Sudan, we have very complicated situations. But Zimbabwe has a very, we don't have as many, you know, ethnic differentiations as the rest of Africa. Yet, immediately after our independence, we had crimes against humanity, a genocide, and ethnic cleansing. I don't want to say ethnicity has caused conflict, because countries that are ethnically homogeneous, like Lesotho, like Somalia, are still fighting now. Is that not the case? And the most ethnically complex countries are living in relative peace. But we come to our Zimbabwean situation because we want to understand this phenomena which we call ethnicity and how it can be used politically, how ethnic mobilization can be effective, and how we have, as a nation, used ethnicity as a defining feature. But when we reflect back, I talk of memory, pre-colonial, colonial, and post-independence, we tend to want to think in terms of ethnicity. I see one sake sona. Whatever, whether he's a soccer player or a businessman, you want to put the ethnicity. I tell you, other nations don't do that. I now live in South Africa. Ethnicity is not a factor. Ethnicity is not a factor in their politics. But in Zimbabwe, we are highly ethnically conscious because we've been using ethnicity to mobilize. You get the point? But ethnicity, in a way, is not something that is actual factual. When we talk of ethnicity, we talk of it as an imagined, as myths, as perceptions. And it, for instance, we've divided this country between Shona and Ndebele. Yet, most of the people you call Ndebele don't even speak the language. Is that not so? Most of the people you call Shona don't even speak the language. They have nothing that links them to that thing. So that identity which we ascribe, we do it because we are politicizing. Is that not so? So we should know that we are talking of perceptions. But those perceptions come to affect us in a devastating manner. So when someone says you are this, you can take offense, rightfully so, because there is a meaning to that title. Self-mirror. But why is this so? Is because our ideology in Africa, not just as about, as what? As Africa. Our liberation was based on nationalism. If you look at what nationalism is based on the belief that the nation, every nation must have its own state. So there must be a relationship between a nation and a state, which is now power, is that so? And in that case, the nation is imagined. Imagine as that community that has common origin, common culture, and a common language. I tell you, that doesn't happen anywhere in the world. You understand this? But nationalism, as an ideology that underpins our society, is based on that perception. And by the way, countries throughout the world, the modern nation states that we see, were not existing in this particular manner. It's a recent phenomenon, which is not as old as it is. So these are problems of modern times because of the way society is now organized. And so it's not peculiar to Zimbabwe. But Zimbabwean ethnicity and its politicization has its own dynamics that are purely Zimbabwe. So when we want to address them, we should address them taking into cognizance our realities, historical, geographical, social, economic development, etc., etc. So in our context in Zimbabwe, it would seem ethnic mobilization becomes the default mode of crisis management, especially by the political elite. The ordinary masses know what they think their identities are, and they don't use them for anything. So ethnicity, socially, culturally, is not a problem. But in its politicization, it becomes a problem. So we are saying the elite, because these things are always done by the elite, be they the political elite, be they the intelligentsia, be it the whoever belongs to that category, are the ones who are managing these perceptions. Nations are actually created by the elite. The rest are just what? Passengers in a bus driven by one driver. So it's important for us to think that way, and why perhaps most scholars shy away into addressing this issue that has been pervasive. So if you ask, is it progress or retrogression? And I've already said that Zimbabwe neatly divides between those fortunate groups enjoying opportunities and the politically and economically excluded. Since this division is unsustainable in my view, it leads to national disintegration, mistrust, suspicion, and internal instability. Then can we say we are harvesting progress from the ethnic factor? As one colleague from the media last week when we were discussing, he said, there are no spoils from an ethnic conflict, and he was dead right. As the elite, you can pursue ethnic mobilization because sometimes it can pay you, but it's not sustainable. That I can bet myself. It's never sustainable. Go to Yugoslavia or wherever, you'll see that it doesn't work. But it is still there with societies thrown away, and it is still a factor in Zimbabwe. But how does it play itself out to be this destructive? We must remember that at the heart of the decolonization process, the liberation struggle, there were two issues that were fundamental. It was the issue of identity, it was the issue of the economy. Either people were fighting for economic rights, or they were fighting because as a people, as a nation, they were oppressed. Is that clear? So those issues were serious. The white race under UDI was protecting a certain identity with its privileges. The African nationalists was fighting for the rights of the Africans, hoping also to get certain opportunities economically. So the conflict has always been on the issues of identities and on the issues of economy. But we know that what is in the economy sphere is factual, is real, is not so. But what is on the identity is perceived. Identities keep on changing. So that you get a better pay. So you can see that identity is not fixed. Hadebe can be this today. You get the point? And I'm free to do so. I am free to do so because it's a construct. It's something that we imagine. And in this case, we put the politicization of ethnicity for a particular cause. But this problem, which we have, was foreseen by African leaders towards the independence of Africa, which is why the Organization of African Unity, when it was formed, it said colonial boundaries would be sacrosanct, they won't be changed. They were trying to deal with the issue of what? Ethnic fragmentation. They did not want you to restore pre-colonial nations. Set up politically. And is that not a fact?
Yeah.
But the fact is, as Africans, don't remember you are part of the what? Of the African community. You have agreed that African countries will be decided on the basis of the colonial division. What happened in Berlin from 1884 to 1885, partitioning Africa, creating African countries, is what as Africans we have agreed we are going to live by. Now when you fude la pilizwe, elinga kiwana na makiwa, au vunyele Africa, liya was gonna. Are you aware of that?
Yeah.
In Africa, we have waki nizwe, we have waki nizwe. So when you thought you were fighting for decolonization, you were actually fighting to maintain colonial what? System. That's the reality. And that's why we've had few rearrangements, like the one that happened in Sudan. But the issue was, because Africans, all Africans, had been enslaved for more than 500 years. And it, from slavery to Berlin, it moved to colonial oppression. Is that not so? So the belief was that the African has suffered so much indignity. The African has suffered what? So much indignity, so much humiliation, that no African can ill-treat another African. That is why your slogan was, until the rest of Africa is free, no Africa is independent. That Ghana's independence is null and void if the rest of Africa is still what? Because the belief was, as long as an African is in charge, he or she will take care of his brother. But you are answering, am I my brother's keeper? Little did we know that Africans will butcher each other more than what the colonial master did. Is that not a fact?
Yes.
We saw more genocide, including in this country, from fellow brothers and sisters. What happened in Biafra? What happened in Rwanda? You get the point. But the belief was, morally, we have suffered together. Even if we differ here and there, there is no way you can treat me like the white race. You get the mentality. So it was a belief that we can create these countries in spite of the different cultures, different languages, but that's not the issue. Because we've been suffering what? As Africans. From a Marxist point of view, we usually say the class dimensions were underplayed in Africa. We should have seen ourselves as the struggling masses, as the workers, is that also? As the oppressed, and free ourselves collectively. But we saw ourselves more in ethnic legs, which is also a created what? A identity. And in the Zimbabwean case, unfortunately, we have the Shona ethnic groups, largely by virtue of their numerical superiority and geographical location of the center of power in their territory, became the heirs and main beneficiaries of independent Zimbabwe. When this name for this country, Zimbabwe, was decided, it did not mean Shona. Babu Kume. People were asked around to go and look for names to name the country which was then called Rhodesia, which was really an insult to our pride. Is that also? And many names were what? Were suggested. Including Omatoje. This country could have been called Matoje. This country could have been called Zambezi. Is that also? But Zimbabwe seemed to be very attractive because Zimbabwe is the center of our ancestors. I'm saying our ancestors, collectively. Zimbabwe is now more removed from the immediate. Is that also? So everyone could have claimed that this is what our ancestors built. You get the point? So that name was chosen to be the rally point for all Africans, is that not so? But as the liberation movement moved on, and as ethnic nationalism, as opposed to territorial nationalism, took hold, Zimbabwe-ness was reduced to the Shona past, is that not so? And we ended up taking symbols that only belong to one culturally and linguistic and ethnic group, and they used them as if they are national. You get the point? So the project was what? Was narrowed. It doesn't mean it's permanent, because that was an imagination anyway. Is that not so? Zimbabwe does not belong to one group. Zimbabwe belongs to all of us. Is that not a fact? Which is just an imagination and a pursuit by the elite for their advantages, hence creating serious problems, and the problems that have brought to fore what some people have called the materiality question. Whether you like it or not, since I said I didn't want to talk about this question, but since I'm talking about it, there are claims now that there is a materiality what? Question, where people are saying, should the people of materiality always play second what?
Fiddle.
Should the burden of Zimbabwean unity rest on the leader from materiality? Now, so from Kamli's gay, about with Hangman's and Jabu's at Tabulani, it is. But you don't say the same thing of a leader who comes from that. And a Kamli's gay is normal, right? Then I can't do it on the materiality. But you know, those who know history, that the leaders from the city, Yotili, Kerarotikere, Malaboba, they moved to meet the leaders from Materiali,
yeah.
And said, guys, to deal with the whites, let's come together. I thought they must have put the terms of engagement. I thought they must have put the terms of what? Of engagement, to say we need one liberation movement to deal with this enemy. And we are saying we don't know with the time whether leaders from this part of the country and leaders from the rest of the country still have rules of what? Of engagement. Because like their scholars, of which I'm part of, they want to shy away from the reality that ethnicity is a factor in Africa and more so in Zimbabwe, because we have thousands and thousands who died, not because of who they are, but because of someone who believes that they belong to this identity. You get the point? So it's an issue that is very sensitive, that is fluid, that is problematic, but that we cannot shy away from. But the elite from materiality, I'm not saying the people of materiality, but the people of materiality have no problem, right? The problem is always between the elites, right? The elites who say they represent the Shona, and the elites who say they represent materiality.
Yeah.
The elite who say they represent Mashona, and the elite who say they represent materiality. How have the elite from the material region responded? I feel they've responded in various ways. The common response has been submission and subordination, in some cases, to degrading levels. Some leaders from the region assumed that being assimilated was being politically correct, as they act as frontline defenders of the status quo. Secondly, there are those who pretend they were wrong in the first place, to have fought for equality and justice for all. They tend to be revisionist as part of seeking accommodation with the powerful. There are those in the majority who play along as much as is possible and wear happy faces, but hoping that God will deliver them from evil. They see the problems and prefer the safety of silence and collaboration, saying it as it is. Then there are those who have barely been rewarded and have nothing to lose, partly because some are in the diaspora and some are in the fringes of political activism. They say whatever they do, most of it on WhatsApp is also, and they can speak. So you're not sure whether there is there an issue here or no issue, because no one comes mainstream raising issues which are so fundamental in the creation of this country. So, in a nutshell, there has been a perception that the burden of Zimbabwean unity is weighing heavy on the shoulders of material leaders, while the majority group often cares less, hence reinforcing the myth that some are more Zimbabwean than others. My comrade and colleague, Professor Kajeli, wrote a book and posed, "Are they Zimbabweans?" Is that so? Before people read the book, they started accusing, "What do you mean?" Because some people feel they must protect being Zimbabwean. When I went to Parliament after the devolution petition, some MPs were saying this is going to what? Divide the country. Do you know how I silenced them? The honourable members. I said, why do you think what I am saying, because I come from my family, will divide the country? Why do you think I'm less patriotic? Because I am patriotic, ladies and gentlemen, and I'm not ashamed of it. So I say my mind because no one is superior to me in patriotism. I belong to this country. But few of people from the region can stand up and talk strongly and say, I am patriotic, I don't want this for my country. And which country? I mean Zimbabwe, by the way. You get the point? So we have a situation where people have accepted being low-class, what? Citizens, being less patriotic. And I say, if I were to be an enemy of Zimbabwe and I want to attack Zimbabwe, where will I attack from? General, which direction will you come from if you want to attack Zimbabwe?
Yes, one side.
Nabi?
Yes, one side.
Utena?
He's talking about outside.
If he is, someone wants to attack from outside, which is the entry point where the government was operating his right? You see why the people in Harare don't see the danger they are doing? First and foremost, before I go straight to the topic, I want to thank the 14 civil society organizations that put forward a solidarity message after what took place in a funeral in Buera, where we are burying our esteemed president of the movement, that is Dr. Okay, Richard Fagler. I'm sure this is why I'm saying I will speak in Cinderella, because what most of you heard or read about what took place in Buera, in this part of the region, is taboo. As long as you grew up in this place, you know what took place there is taboo. I'm not going to go into the merits and demerits of what took place there. Anyway, Chairman, when your topic is ethnic factor in Zimbabwe politics, progressive or retrogressive? Is it progressive or is it retrogressive? We call it more progressive. I'm trying to get in the room, but I'm going to be in the room. To me, and maybe to you, I have not seen any progress. We are not only progress in ethnic politics. Why am I saying that? Now I'm gonna I'm a commander, I'm a message that I end up Kuma Bawas in this. Why is it is not progressive? In 1979, after a protracted struggle, Kwavunye Ramda Sambe is a Shalapal Skunza. Kwahanjwa wa Shalapal is a Lancaster of Britain. Kwavunye lwa na wasa inelwa na pals. Sign. Na mapikicha mkuna loke kone na mtlanje mkwa mwolo mkabe la banyo le saina. Ukuthi sesisiya eZimbabwe sizafika sivote ndawonye singabantwana beZimbabwe akade besilwa nabalungu sizindawonye siyipatriotic front. Ababekhona yikho kwayenzakala temina za point ukuthi izinto there's no progress as far as I'm concerned, it's not progressive. Because sivumelane la size sisayinelane phansi. But I'm going to do it. 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 I'm going to Sakala Savona, I'm a comrade. I must send the points. esebulala. Babe bulala na on ethnic lines, ethnic divisions. Laba ngathi kuyinto nje izinto engizijengisa ukuthi sihamba. Is there any progress in ethnic politics? Angiyiboni. Zukuzuku uhulumende ngokwakhe esebenzisa futhi ethnicity wayatraina amasotsha eNorth Korea. Angilandisi ukuthi kwenzakalani. Akula progress khonapho. Kuthe nakusiyafona i-MDC esilayo namhlanje. Yafonwa isiseke kumekithi foundation yayo yayi-ZCT. U-ZCTU, u-president we-ZCTU kwakungubaba u-Gibson Zibani. U-secretary general kungu-Morgan Tsvangirai. Njengoba yayi-foundation abanye abaningi kukhona elalimkhangelele. But kuthe kufika ngani kwagcina sokutshintshela. Those are facts, kubuhlungu, but at times ukukhuluma iqiniso ngoba ukuthi sikorrekte kuthiwa nxa ufuna ukuthi isilonda siphole ngoba ithumba liphole ungaligezisa libhandithi likhambe liphuphu. Zukuzuku namhlanje ihophu yabantu beZimbabwe yonke i-MDC. That's why wonke umuntu esupport MDC. In particular khonapho eMathebeleni. Whether you want to run away from it or you don't, I've got very tangible examples ukuthi MDC's heartbeat is here eMathebeleni.
Yes.
There are 57 districts in Zimbabwe. I want to mention in particular in rural areas. Out of 57, MDC only controls 2 rural district councils. Where are they? Are they in Mashonaland or Mathebeleni? They are here. Those are facts that you can't deny. Now, that's the lack of progress that I'm saying. In terms of ethnicity, akuna progress. Whoever thinks who mobilizes the popularity, yeah? Whoever thinks who mobilizes the popularity should be done using ethnicity. Mugabe, who started it 38 years, and I can bait you, singavele sinyathele enyaweni nalolo. Whoever comes in kuzamthathela 38 years times 2, siloko siku 1 down, sibuyele emuva. Retrogressive. Ungalandeli into zonke engizikhulumileyo. They are all retrogressive. Zonke engizikhulume ezisezifika namhlanje ziyatshengisa ukuthi akulanto enhle i-ethnicity. But we can still learn ukuthi i-ethnicity in other areas or in other parts of the world is progressive. Let me go global to international community. America is one of the superpowers of this world. And the majority people that live in America, amakhiwa, abamhlophe, who some of us view as racist, who I have seen or heard leaders in this country labeling America as racist. But they've been proved that they are liars. America is not racist. It's not a racist country. Because Obama
a black man of Kenya origin ruled America. There was no problem with those people that you labeled racist. But here in Zimbabwe, you will hear someone here in Zimbabwe saying, and the very cannot rule this country. The very same people who are accusing America to be racist. You can't even, now come to the source of the way now. You mean you three come back? Come closer to Africa. Africa as a continent. There was a serious genocide that took place in Rwanda. Serious genocide. Where over 1.2 million people died. And I know some people are saying, according to the United Nations, it is 880,000, something like that, people that died. I have been in Rwanda myself for 2 weeks during inclusive government on a study tour with records. Our records are alamabiso of people that died. They are over 1.2 million. The people that were being attacked were the smaller tribe, the Tutsis. I don't want to go into what happened when they fought. Kodwa emfuna ukuthi ngithi Paul Kagame is a Tutsi from the minority group. Today, the fastest growing economy in Africa is none other than Rwanda. Ibusambad, Mtutsi, the minority. You come here in Zimbabwe, the Bhebhes will never rule Zimbabwe.
Yeah.
I said I want to be honest. I'm from Uti. Go after I'm Kurim Lavandabanga Bazio. You go with Zagan. Come closer to the Sakak region. Just recent. ANC. ANC in South Africa has got so many tribes. One of the smallest tribes in South Africa is a Changani. The president that has just been sworn in South Africa is Ramaphosa, and Ramaphosa is a Changani. Come here in Zimbabwe. And the very member who is in Zimbabwe. That's retrogression and Kumanga. There is whether we have food, the power, we have any problem with super Zimbabwe. From what we learned from God, every other leader of the political party, Guye power is sweet, nothing else. I would rather break the rules as long as I get power. Poison, and the telegraphy, as long as Zimbabwe, you know, pillar, put those who pillar, whom God was 38 years. And whoever comes in, my mentality on a little bit called, multiply 38 by 2. What is the encoding general ethnicity? The ethnicity of Zimbabwe is corrupted around Matebelele and Mashona. The ethnicity of Zimbabwe is corrupted around Mandevele, the Mashona.
Yeah.
Now, let me tell you,
I'm
a product of a Shona in Mandevele. I'm a product of a Shona in Mandevele. Then hamba nje ngikhuluma labantu lapha phakathi komuntu. Na ukhuluma ngemathebeleleni. ukhuluma abantu abahlala ngapha
emathebeleni
abahlala ngapha
komphakathi
lapha emathebeleni nxa ukhuluma ngamandebeli ukhuluma ama ethnic groups amanengi. One thing for sure, those ethnic groups amanengi are include amashona ahlala lapha around lapha. You can't say this man is not a Ndebele. Unless if you want to use a divided list. Who's more than that? Ngoba into yenza into njalo akula mhlobo okuthiwa lindebele in terms of idemography yezibhamu ngosokuthiwa lindebele umuntu ohlala emathebeleni nangithi umvenda kwini umkhalanga kwini umtonga kwini umnguni kwini umshona kwini uyakwazi ukuthi okwenza libone ukuthi umshona umshona kwini uyakwazi ukuthi okwenza libone ukuthi umshona kwini hayi yikuthi iZimbabwean politics has been dominated by ethnic calculation. Umuntu waqalisa ukuthi kube dominated konoko umuntu owayephila emashonaleni umdala. Wakuperpetuator for 38 years. Unfortunately, the breed of politics that is wants to take over from where Mugabe left going forward. I want to be very brutal. I mean, I'm funny with this Kumama. I want to be very brutal. I mean, I'm funny with this Kumama. I problem eba khona ukuthi selize likwazi ukuthi ishona leni lishona but ngona mina engikwaziyo my command sisempini sasikwazi ukuthi ishona lishona but safika lapha ngo 1980 sakufundiswa u Robert Mugabe and the most painful or brutal truth is as long as we walk in the footsteps of Mugabe multiply 38 times 2, look on the same down. You want to show and show. Conoco to the show. I wouldn't talk to the show. Umkaranga, the show. Umzezur, the show. Umkorekor, the show. Umnira, the show. You can mention and mention and mention. Umdebele ohlala emashonaleni. Uyabona khona. But because Mugabe siwasifaka kweyinye imentality wasifaka wasigoqo sakwana futhi. Our politics in Zimbabwe is working or being practiced on the experiences that you learned from Robert Mugabe. Yeah. It was bad. A lot of people are full of I can stay a season. I can stay a season. What did you tell? What did you tell? Love Momo, Bhebhe. I will tell you that always I will lay in reference to the region. It's not about them. It's never about them. It's about them. All of you sitting here. After what I've just said about you, all of you sitting here. Those are only leaders that you dispatched to go and put your views at national level. Bhebhe, it's not about them. But because sasafunda ipolitics sahamba enyaweni zikamgaba. Uzabona abanye besithi lokhana ngokwabo okwakho yikuphi. How can we avoid that? One, then our band to Zimbabwe, we should have tolerance. Then our band to Zimbabwe, we should accept each other. Ngoba umuntu ole idea ebhalwe Zimbabwe. In particular, all this idea of Zimbabwe is a citizen. Ungabona wena sumazi ukuthi khona ukhuluma statement esithi go back to Matebelele. Uyabona abantwana abangabaziyo oba emkhulumayo labo kuqalise khona kule fold khona. Umgabe limkhiphile sehambile. Very soon, nxa uthi uyakhangela iminyaka yakhe, akusensuku zatshwala. Most of you abahlezi lapha who are above 50 njengani. Your life now ungayidweba ngegraph. Your graph has reached to a peak point. Siqalisa ukwehla. But below the graph where it starts, there are other people that are not yet born. They will rely on history, true or false. And I can tell you, if Zimbabwe does not fix the issue of ethnicity, dividing people according to regions, there is going to be civil war here in Zimbabwe in years to come. You can want to say, Bhebhe, you're a man. I know you've got pens here. I know you're recording here. History will tell, even if I am born, even if you are born. Violence. Mo 1999, wafonywa ibandla le MTC. And the ibandla le MDC, the biggest complaint that they had against ZANU-PF is violence. Violence, violence, violence. Ibandla le MDC, the biggest complaint is intimidation, intimidation, intimidation. My biggest question is, what do you call what is happening in MDC? I rest my case. Thank you.